morning to all. Today we are going to discuss about the practical on activity and shift surveying equipment. So why we are going to do that the survey? First of all, we know that the location of particular land and we know that the particular area of piece of land. For this purpose, we can do that the survey. For surveying, there are two activities are involved. One is on field, we can record the measurement, and second one is the to the lab. So first of all, for field, we can measure the distances, and we need the some equipment for the surveying.
Two equipment required for the surveying. So first we can select the chain. So chains are different type of chains are there. Here we are using the metallic chain for the measurement of lengths, and here it is a 20 meter chains, and it contains two brass handles. Here we can represent that the 20 meter chain, and there are the 100 or 150 links are available. For 20 meter chains, 100 links are there. Each link it is 0.2 meters or 20 centimeters, and there are the three rings are there joining of each links. Here they are using that the three links, and it is a 20 meter chains used for the links, and every 5 meters one tally they can fix. Okay, they represent that the 5 meters length, and it is easy to measure that the lengths in decimals also. And here two brass handles are there, two brass handles they can use. There the two persons are required for the measurement of lengths. One is the leader and follower. Tape also we can use for the measurement of distances. Here there are the different tapes are there, and here steel tape we can use for the measurement of distances. Next, coming to ranging rods. So ranging rods are 3 meters height are available. 3 meters are available, and here you can see there are the different markings are there. White and red markings are there. Some ranging rods black and white are there. Yellow and black is there. So these markings every 0.2 meters are available, and these ranging rods we can use for the fixing of main station and end station. These are the arrows we can use for the fixing of end of the chain. Every end of the chain we can use these arrows to fix. Crosstaff are used for the fixing of right angles, and here we can measure that the triangulation process, we can fix that the right triangles. This is the plumb bob we can use for the fixing of ranging rods in a straight position. This is a optical square we can use for the fixing of right angles, and we can fix that the right angle for the longer distances. Before going to start a surveying, first inspect that the area. Thoroughly you can inspect that the area. After inspection of thoroughly area, then we can take that the ranging rod and we can fix for the main station. After fixing of main station, and we can fix that the end station also. And from main station to end station, we can make a main line. It is called main line, joining of end station to main station. And you can also install that the intermediate station between the main lines. And we can fix the end boundaries for over the boundary area. And this is the overview of the measured area. So there are the four boundaries are fixed, main line and end stations. And here we can draw that the rough diagram in a notebook. Here we can go for the chaining. So first you can hold that the chain in two hands, brass handle in left hand and chain in right angle, and you can spread that the chain. For chaining process, two persons are required. One is leader and follower, and here we can place that the chain in this position. After placing up chain, we can press a arrow at the end of the chain. And here we can fix that the arrow. After that we can go for the chaining again. And here we can measure that the area length. So here you can see we can count out the link after 20 meters chain. Link 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and half. So here each link 20 centimeter or 0.2 meters. So 20 plus link 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into 0.2, 0.8 meters plus 0.1, 0.9. So total length is 20 plus 0.9 meters, 20.9 meters. This chaining process repeat for from point A to B, B to C, C to D, and the main line from A to C. And you can record that the data in field book. So like that we can record that the all the measurements of all four sides.
Completion of field measurements, you can take your rough diagram and come to the lab and you can draw that the rough diagram. Here point A, B, C and D. And you can, this is a main line and the length is 20.9 meters and AC is 15 meters and CD is 16.2 meters and BD is 14.5 meters and DA is 4.5 meters. After recording of this diagram, and we can calculate that the area of three known sides of triangles by using the Heron's formula. Heron's formula. Then we can calculate that the area of each triangle. So the formula is triangle ABC is equal to S into under root of S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C, where S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. Here S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. Here A, B, C are sides of the triangle. So the S is equal to 26.05 from these values. And the triangle ABC is equal to S into under top S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So here S minus A 5.96, S minus B 11.05 and then S minus A 9.85. Multiplying of these values and we are getting the area of ABC is 338.36 meters square. And similarly we can calculate same for this triangle also. This is second triangle and this is first triangle. Then triangle ABD, area of this is 1281.24 meters square. And the total area of this particular piece of land is triangle ABC plus triangle BDA, that is 338.36 plus 1281.24 is equal to 1690.844 meters square. So like that we can calculate the area of piece of land. Thank you.